Welcome back. Today's video is a quick reference to teach you how to install a BMS on some LiFePO4 cells. So we're going to be using this Deligreen 4S 200 amp BMS. We also have the temperature probe and the balance harness here, as well as some ring terminals. We have the bus bars for our batteries, the nuts, and a few different tools. Now getting started, I've pre-applied some VHB tape to the back of this BMS. And I'm actually going to just stick that right over here on the side of these batteries. Now you may be wondering about these leads. I've gone ahead already and removed the screws from them and flipped the leads around so that it's a little bit easier to get these on the battery. So now that that's in place, we need to get some ring terminals put on our balance lead. And that's as simple as just stripping them back and crimping on some terminals. Now for this, we find it's easiest just to twist the wire and then fold it in half before sticking on the ring terminal. That way these tiny wires get a better bite in the ring terminals. And we recommend the ring terminals that utilize heat shrink. With this balancing harness now prepared, we can begin wiring up our battery. Now this battery is already arranged in a crisscross negative positive configuration. So when I put these bus bars in place, I'm effectively putting these batteries in series. So let's break down this battery into the four cells. We have cell one, cell two, cell three, and cell four. Our black wire in this harness, there's five wires, four of them are red, one of them is black. The black wire is gonna go on cell one negative. The first red wire is gonna go on cell one positive. The second red wire is gonna go onto cell two positive. The third red wire onto cell three positive, and the fourth red wire onto cell four positive. And then we can get all the nuts put in place for these. When you're installing the last one for fourth cell positive, you're going to want to actually install your battery cable first and then the balance lead, and then you can put the nut on. When you're installing the black wire on cell one negative, you also want to include the B minus terminal from the BMS. And then once everything is put in place, I'm going to use my ratchet and tighten everything down to a proper amount of torque. At this point, we effectively have everything wired up. If we were to plug this in and everything were wired correctly, we'd be good to go. But I want to double check that everything is right. So on this harness, I'm going to check every adjacent pin. And if every adjacent pin is showing around 3.3 volts, that means I have everything wired up correctly. So now we can plug this into the back of the BMS. Now these BMSs will not turn on unless the low temperature sensor is plugged in, and that plugs into the NTC port on the side of the BMS. So now when I check from positive to the negative of this BMS, it's still showing 9 volts. There's one more step here, and that's going to be connecting it to a charger. So I have a 12 volt inverter charger right here. I'm going to go ahead and connect these wires up to this charger, and then with a nut and bolt, we can attach the P minus cable to our load. Now, if we flip the switch on this inverter, it still doesn't turn on because the BMS hasn't had charge current through it to activate it. So I'm gonna plug this in so that as soon as the inverter does turn on, it goes into charge mode. And I'm gonna briefly touch P minus to B minus. And now with these touching, I can turn the inverter on. It's gone into charge mode. And now when I stop touching these two together, it's actually charging the battery, the BMS is active, and if I unplug the AC power from the inverter, it's now in invert mode and ready to power our loads, and we're good to go. This BMS is ready for use. Now the only thing you're gonna wanna do is apply some heat shrink to this connection from P minus to our output cable, or utilize a bus bar similar to this one in order to make all of your connections nice and clean. Now for reference, these batteries right here are the EnerAmp EA170 LiFePO4 cell. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below and be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Hope to see you guys in the next one. Have a great day.
You're watching Current Connected. Check out our website at www.currentconnected.com.